Hello, my lovelies. Happy Valentine's Day and welcome to the joinDOTA production of WePlay Season 3. We continue with Southeast Asian Dota from their lovely little group stage. And my date for today, or at least this morning, is Heen. How are you doing, man? 5 seconds
remaining. Hey, man. It's night for me, but not that it really matters.
It's a dinner date. It's fine. But yeah, tiring against TNC, we've got two best of ones coming up for you here to play each other once and then once again. As we kick things off into the draft, we can actually just chat a little bit about the group stage so far. Mineski, they had their first loss the other day against MVP Phoenix. They're currently 8-1. TNC are 5-4, but Taring have only played 3 games so far. They're 3-0, unbeaten. But this is going to be the test. This is going to be that bridge they have to cross to get themselves up to the top with Mineski. If they can beat TNC twice here, I think they're in pretty good stead to run through. But of course, Fnatic, still 0 games played, so there's honestly everything to play for. Draft kicks off. Jaro Void banned. Lone Druid OD taken out. Taring with the Dazzle Nature's Prophet. And then TNC come out straight with a Vengeful Spirit and Spirit Breaker. Interesting stuff. I mean, these two teams, they both have kind of specific play styles. Taring has liked the... They've really loved the 25-minute timing push. Like, every time I've seen them, the games have ended by 20 to 25 minutes. They just run towards the enemy base, and they try and end the game. While TNC is a little more back and forth. But I don't know how they're going to pair up against each other.
You know, the last time I saw Taring was quite a while ago. It was almost 2 weeks. And I think Taring was, they seem to be at, the height of their potential, in terms of, I've never seen them play such a clean game. The last game I saw of them was, when they picked Weaver in the safe lane, and I was, skeptical at first, but they, I don't remember who the opponent was, but they completely stomped them. And as for TNC, I think I've seen a lot of shaky games from them. The last time I saw them play against Mineski, they sort of got wrecked, no other way to put it. But seeing as how even Mineski, who I just mentioned, they were 8-0, and was it yesterday or the day before against MVP, they got completely wrecked. So this SEA region is completely unpredictable. I'm not gonna, I'm not gonna make predictions. I've kind of lost the motivation. I'm always wrong.
It's super topsy-turvy. One team, let's say Mineski, they go 8-0. They beat MVP Phoenix 2 weeks ago. Pretty easily, and yeah, like you said, it was 2 days ago, it was Friday, I think it was, where MVP played against Mineski, and it was a 19-minute game. It was over at 10 minutes. It was absolutely insane. I think the same thing for Taring. They kind of have to keep, they have to keep that morale high. They've hit their stride, but if they do make a misstep, things can come crumbling down, as we've seen from a lot of other teams. But with this draft so far, they've got what they love. Pushing power, global presence, Nature's Prophet can TP around, make up the numbers in the team fights. Dazzle keeps people alive. And then the Juggernaut with the Healing Ward. Going to help out immensely as well. While TNC, they like the Spirit Breaker in the 4 role. And I'm just wondering if they might have to switch this up and go for something like an Ancient Apparition just to try and stall these pushes with the level 6 Ice Blast.
I think TNC has a track record of often dual laning the Spirit Breaker, so they'll pick Spirit Breaker plus some other offlaner, like a Darkseer, or it can be really anything as long as it can lane against the Juggernaut and create pressure on him. And then with Avenge, they usually like to pair it with some of the strong range carries, like a Drow Ranger or the Gyro, which is banned. That's how I would predict it, but knowing TNC, they do have the TNC-esque these drafts that you've seen before. Visage pickup. Oh boy, is this gonna be a Drow? Because Drow Visage Venge is
disgusting.
Just a cookie cutter try trio.
Looks like that might be the way they're going, and this is the classic way to pick it up as well. You've got support, you've got a kind of brawling hero, your offlane and Spirit Breaker picked up, then another support, which is the Visage, more often than not, is the third pick. And then it was always the fourth pick Drow, because you pick the Visage and your opponents, they're just shit, they're going to pick Drow, aren't they? Do we block pick it? Do we pick it ourselves? Do we just let them have it? How do we deal with this? But recently, we've seen a lot of Drow Rangers picked in first phase, just randomly picked up here and there. It's been more of a kind of whimsical pick, we'll pick Drow here, rather than the really systematic kind of algorithmic Venge, Spirit Breaker, Visage, Drow Ranger, which we used to see a hell of a lot of. But TNC, Come on, show us the money. Is it the Raven Drow Ranger? Because Taring have picked up an Earth Spirit. That nasty little devil's going to be roaming from lane to lane. And honestly, he's pretty good at getting up in the face of that Drow. When she's trying to stay her distance and keep those arrows flying.
Yo, my initial thought was that between you and me, like I think we've casted about 7 or 8 Drow games in the past 2 weeks. And to be honest, Drow had a pretty low win rate. I honestly don't remember Drow winning a game. It was always like Drow getting ripped apart by Lycan or just like never really got to the items like against MVP against Mineski. Drow just completely got wrecked. But it's TNC, and if there's one team in SEA region that represents Drow, it has to be TNC. So they might be the team that kind of breaks, you know, the bad streak of losses on Drow we've been seeing.
10 seconds remaining.
But I think they're kind of they're Five deciding. Yeah, they're gonna go for the Ember Spirit. Dire they might still pick Drow, but I think Ember is the safer hero than Drow. It doesn't really show too much, and it doesn't get countered by a single hero.
Oh, we'll see what they do with it. Ember Spirit. Interesting stuff. I mean, he's got some global presence. He's pretty good up against Taring's lineup because, honestly, what lockdown do they have up against him outside of Earth Spirit? It's going to be a rough one keeping that Ember Spirit on tabs, honestly.
It's also a lot better than most carries with the Spirit Breaker and the Visage, like this, these kind of chaotic teamfight heroes that need to be mobile.
Well, Taring, what are you going to be banning out now? 5th ban, 2 supports off laner, and it's going to be safe lane Ember Spirit for... Oh god, that just epitomizes, you know, TNC's drafting style, right? What are they going to pick? Who the hell knows? That's Banner Chaos Knight. It's something they've played before. Oh man. I was actually wondering if it's going to be Teehee Ember mid, because that's something he's played before in the past. Although...
Yeah, definitely.
10 seconds
although
remaining.
When Raven joined them, and... Actually, it was Raven replaced Teehee and then Teehee came back. Yeah, when Raven replaced Teehee, when Teehee went to study, Raven started playing the Ember Spirit for them. So I know for sure he can play it, but I don't know where they're going to put this hero in what lane. But Zeus is the final pickup for Taring and TNC. I'm assuming safe laner, just for the Teehee Ember mid. What kind of hero would you look for here?
I think they want something that goes BKB because Ember Spirit is surprisingly bad against Zeus. Zeus can use just 2 spells and you suddenly don't have flame guard during the mid game, which means you just can't fight. You don't do that much DPS without flame guard early on. You kind of rely on it.
Bounty Hunter.
And a Bounty Hunter.
Revenge Call?
I suppose so.
Looks like it.
I completely just erased the possibility of Vengeful as a carry because I'm too used to seeing TNC play Vengeful as like that super... They don't play to the defensive support. It's like the kind of roaming, roam with the other support.
The boots first, buy smokes, go and kill stuff.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Well, Sam H on the Spirit Breaker, so it's going to be Roaming Bounty Hunter. You can really kind of trace the Earth Spirit's movements, I feel. You know, they've got these mirrored supports going to be roaming around and causing havoc on the mid lane. Teehee's Ember Spirit, of course, with Yamate on the Zeus. Let's find out how exactly the lane is, because there's technically the potential here for TNC to go for some kind of aggro lane. I mean, it's not a high percentage chance. You know, Bounty Hunter very likely is just going to be roaming around, but he could be the one that kind of forces the Earth Spirit to stay away from these other lanes. Maybe try and track his movements. Oh, dear.
Oh, Dazzle.
Oh, dear. That was an error. I'm glad I caught that. Just about saw it. Actually, who is the Dazzle, actually?
Oh, he sold it, so... You sell it for half the cost, I guess. Like, 45 gold?
Oh, wait. Really?
Isn't that how it works?
Wait, so he bought Dust, used it, and then sold it for half of 90?
Well... Yeah.
So there's one charge left and he sold it because he'd used... Oh god, that's a shame.
Oh, I think he saw, the ward.
Yeah, he definitely did. Well, TNC Teehee Ember Spirit, Winter G Small Sun over on the Visage, Raven playing that one roll Vengeful Spirit down here, and Sam H over on the Spirit Breaker. Well, AU's going to be that roaming bounty hunter. He's got all the venom, he's got tangos, he's got all of the tools he needs to ward and deward and cause havoc on these lanes. While Ben is up on top with the Juggernaut, Mango Stout Shield is his starting build up. While 3-4-3, you buying more Obs and Sentries? What's going on here? Ice is a Nature's Prophet going to go down to bot lane, but the Love Heart, the Dazzle, the Duster in the Fountain. He's already wasted a bit of gold. He's got Sentries and a shared Tango. Things have not started well for Team Taring here, but it should be all okay. Should be fine. Bounty Runes just going to get traded across as they normally do. One apiece for the mid laners. Yamate gets one, as well as Teehee towards the mid. But this bot lane, Nature's Prophet, against a Visage Venge, I guess early on he's going to have a reasonably good time. Just with the Treants harassing out Vengeful Spirit, she's not got a good amount of range. Her damage is decent, but he should be able to TP out of most of these situations.
I think he should be fine until Venge and Visage hit level 3. Then he might not have time to TP out. He's just going to die to the burst. But that said, though, he's gonna get some levels, but he has to be careful with the tree. Like, oh, the tree died. This is super bad for Nature's Prophet right now.
Oh, mid lane is a battle of a 2v2 here. Teehee is going up against Yamate, then you've got AU going up against 3-4-3. Earth Spirit and Bounty Hunter, they are just tracing each other's patterns, but with the Zeus having this kind of advantage with Arc Lightning and the static field, he's kind of forcing Teehee back, who hasn't leveled anything up yet. He's still holding on to that. I guess you're waiting for level 2 Flame Guard. To go into that, and then maybe for the Sleight of Fist. I guess it
Flame
depends.
Guard is going to be pretty useless until rank 2 against Zeus. And that's one of the reasons I think Zeus is underrated against Ember Spirit. A lot of people might assume that just like Ember has a free lane against Zeus, but that's really not the case.
AU misses out on the career snipe mid. He walks through between the towers, but he's not going to find anything up there. Where these lanes are going, up at top, Sam H is just biding his time, getting levels up here. Now, that's something that we haven't kind of really pointed out, is we're looking at Earth Spirit and Bounty roaming around, you know, being annoying little bastards that they are, hitting people and punching people around. If there's a 2v2 mid, the Spirit Breaker can come in and make it a 3v2. And then Nature's Prophet comes in and makes it a 3v3. Both of these teams have heroes that kind of just dogpile in and make up the numbers. I still have a nice little steal there on the Bounty rune, actually. Scouting out the Visage with his Treants, TPing out to get the Bounty, while up at top, a regen rune for Yamate as he actually kicks Teehee back into the Lightning here. The zaps coming from Yamate are pretty big, but AU's there to trade hits with 3-4-3, and the charge is coming across. Earth Spirit, he dusts up the Bounty Hunter. This could be a kill on 3-4-3. No, they back themselves away, and Teehee barely surviving there to Yamate's burst damage. If only he was level 4. You have that level 2 lightning bolt and absolutely crush him. But Teehee doesn't have... Oh, he's got enough money for bottle now. But he's going to have to walk back to his tier 1 to pick it up and regen.
Yeah, Teehee was kind of greedy in a way. He could have just got a salve. And salves are super value against Zeus because obviously Zeus without mana. That's when you have a free lane. But he wanted to get that full bottle... charge.
Oh, they
want to
try
for the salve.
They want to try on Yamate. They've got the slow. Oh no, they don't. They don't. AU waited too long with the hits in there. They had level 2 chains, and well, I guess Flame Guard was coming off cooldown in 10 seconds. And may not have been a kill, but that would have been a lot of pressure onto that Zeus. Oh, Vengeful Spirit down the bottom lane, 19-6, farming away like a boss. Ice. He's getting his levels though. That's one of the big things here. Is like you were saying before, the Venged Visage kind of hit their level 3, level 4. With the level 2 Soul Assumption, and the Vengeful Spirit with the bigger stuns and the bigger nuke damage. This little Nature's Prophet should be fine. That's what AU's made his move. He's coming in. He wants date night. He wants a hug. He's not going to get anything, though. Ice felt it coming. And he backs himself away.
I really like the lane dynamics this game. It's like super tense in all the lanes because of how many, just like the bounty roaming, Earth Spirit roaming, the global potential from Nature's Prophet, not to mention when Zeus hits level 6.
Oh, they're going to kill Sam H. Like,
fights all over the map.
Yo, charge! Charge! Ooh. He's going to tick over to the poison.
Oh
the kick!
God.
The kick!
Oh
he got
god.
In the fairy fire! Oh my god, he's alive! 20 HP and he settles up. Whew. You were speaking what about tents and oh my god, my butt clench there for him. Yamate mid, he's going to get chased down. TE with the flame guard. Oh, this might be a kill. They burn through the flame guard though. Yamate clears it up with the lightning bolt. There's the fairy fire from him as well, but he's going to get cleared up. The haste rune from TE will take him down. Okay, guys. I've succeeded. I didn't miss first blood. Across all three lanes, we've had so much action. I've been so panicky here. But first blood goes the way of TNC. And that Ember Spirit picks it up, but the push comes in. Taring say, you know what? We've got this big old pushing lineup with a healing ward, Nature's Prophet. We'll shove into your towers as quickly as possible. While Vengeful Spirit Visage can't really do the same thing.
Yeah, surely not. I think had Taring gotten that first blood on Sam H, that would have been so big. Because already they already probably drafted this lineup, this Juggernaut, offlane, Nature's Prophet duo. Almost unstoppable push, especially with TNC's lineup. Teehee, after getting a first blood like that though, it should put him like pretty comfortably. He's gonna hit level 6 before Zeus hits level 6, which means he can dive Zeus, and it's gonna take a bit for Zeus to take off the flame guard. Here we go.
Oh, they're jumping in, but there's the kick on 2 and the roll in onto Teehee. Yamate's dead already, and Teehee turns around and takes the Earth Spirit with him. Surviving with the magic stick charges, TNC. This mid lane is going spectacularly for them. How much gold was that? That's a good 400 gold apiece between Bounty and Ember Spirit. But I think the bigger thing is that Bounty Hunter, we've seen time and time again, you know, Bounty Hunter roaming around. He doesn't really do much sometimes. And he's sort of sitting around 6-7 minutes in. He's level 2, level 2.5, level 3. And he's thinking, how do I get to my track? How do I get there? This game, he shouldn't have too much of a problem getting to that level 6 with the assists and the kills.
Oh, definitely not. He's having a fantastic game. Level 4.5 at 6 minutes is very respectable on Bounty Hunter. It means he's been...
Oh, man.
No, he has been winning.
They're doing it again. Yamate's being bullied! Whew! Bloody! TP is coming thick and fast in mid lane, and the roll in onto AU will catch him, but the Sprout! It pushes AU away and only traps 3-4-3. They had 3 TPs come in between Nature's Prophet, Dazzle, and the Juggernaut come in. But TNC, leaves in the wind. Let's flutter away. Get themselves to these side lanes and keep on farming. And you look at Raven, right? This Vengeful Spirit, early game carry, who's been left alone completely. This Venge is going to be an absolute monster. So I think Taring kind of have to slow things down. Radiant's but how do you go about this?
I think Taring has to be really careful about trying to force stuff like that. The top tower was kind of, it's part of their lineup. They're supposed to get it for free. But because Zeus is getting kind of shat on this game, not that Yamate is really making that many mistakes, they have to be really careful or they're going to get busted when, you know, Ember Spirit's level 7. He can probably tank all 3 of Zeus' spells, and then he'll get the Flame Guard taken off. And what I'm trying to say is that if Taring tried to force the issue, TNC might be able to bust it, and if Bounty Hunter has track and Radiant's they get busted, oh, it's going to be so hard for Taring. They're going to lose, like, 3k gold in one fight.
Yamate, oh, that's a good grave. They've got nothing to stun him up just now. The swap had already been used. Dazzle will drop the Flame Guard in the back as Furion. He's furiously trying to take out Raven, but Teehee's back up. He's got Remnants and Searing Chains in a second. Good kick across as Teehee. I guess he's got a Remnant defensively, but he's gonna jump himself away. The Omni Slash is dodged, but Teehee's dying to Roche! He gets killed off by the big man as Ben is chased back behind his tier 1. Slowed out by the Grave Chill. AU unfortunately just hits level 6 off that kill, so there's no tracks coming out. And the Thunder God's Wrath. Not killing anybody, in fact. Oh man, Yamate, no. Sam H, cancel the charge. Bail yourself out of this one because the rolling boulder, he's coming in and he ain't got no moss. He'll catch him with the kick, the roll across. And this should be the death of Sam H here. He's got no regen. And finally, Taring get themselves up on the board. Their first kill of the game.
Yeah, slight overextension by Sam H, but at that point it didn't matter. This T is super carrying this early game right now. I think there was one mistake when he let the Zeus TP out. I think he could have just, you know, remnanted onto the Zeus and killed the creeps and got the Searing Chains off.
AU. Ooh, they've got dust. They've got double dust. Double dust, double death. AU's gone. But look at Yamate's life. Oh my god, he's got to try and TP out of here. He'll be safe. He'll be okay. The charge coming through. He'll get himself back to the fountain. Taring. They're finally getting something.
If they realize that Tihi TP top, they should be able to kind of stay their ground and realize that it's going to be hard for TNT to save this tower. Because they need every tower they need right they can get right now. Bounty on it. Oh, he has to be careful with dust. The new dust cooldown. It's only 30 seconds.
He's going to get rolled up on Shuriken. It will bounce onto Dazzle. AU's tanky, though, with the urn he's got. He's actually surviving through it. And the charge across three here. The clear up the Dazzle. Chase down Ice as well. Thunderous Wrath doesn't even finish off AU. He's on 10 HP. 18 health with a final spell out from Earth Spirit. They do clear him up. That grip magically caught him. Magnetized the bounty with that Shuriken. Shoved up his backside, but Taring, they lost the Juggernaut up at top. I missed out on that one as the fight was breaking down at bottom lane. Ember Spirit killed off the Juggernaut alone.
Yeah, I suppose that shouldn't happen, but it kind of works both ways. Usually Juggernaut shouldn't be able to kill the Ember Spirit, but Ember Spirit, if he's kind of like hiding in the trees and Radiant's sees that Juggernaut doesn't have Blade Fury, he can go for the kill.
Dyer's They've got level 6 on the Visage now as well. What does this mean for Taring? What do they do about the birdies?
I don't think TNT is in any rush. They can basically play this game out as a fight fest. They can just smoke gank, just charge the Zeus over and over again, get track kills. Perfect location. Taring's the one that kind of wants all these towers gone. I mean, they did get all the tier 1s, which is really nice for them. Had they gotten like team wipe while trying to get a tier 1s, it would have been hard for them to gain that control. Because if you look at TNC's lineup, I think they made a conscious decision to make it a nightmare for Nature's Prophet. Bounty Hunter, annoying for Nature's Prophet. Ember Spirit, if he ever catches you on the same screen, like if you back like 2 seconds too late, you're dead. Same for like Spirit Breaker. Venge and Visage, I guess, don't really hunt the Nature's Prophet too well, but they're not afraid of Nature's Prophet, basically.
Oh, Yamate, not like this, not again, Sam H. Oh, you've been zapped down, my friend. He heals himself up a little bit, and Yamate should be able to zap him again. With the Arc Lightning, he got a little bit too big for his boots as Sam H. charged straight on.
Yeah, I'm surprised Raven didn't swap him.
Oh, TP in. Taring aren't done. Winter, gee, small son. Are you just going to get taken out? The long-range projectile from Ice will clear it up, and all of a sudden, Taring are in a position where they can take a tier 2 and then maybe go and take Roshan.
Yeah, but I'm not sure if this tier 2. Are TNC really gonna let this go? Dire's top tower is under attack. I guess so. Spirit Breaker, Sam H just charged mid. Dire's top
tower has fallen. Oh, they're bailing out. Raven, Helm of the Dominator. What do we have for the Ember Spirit? He's got his BOTs, right? Boots of Travel, Drum's nearly done. Just wants to tank up as much as he can against the Zeus and Earth Spirit. Well, Juggernaut, he's had a rough old game, 0-2-0. What's his net worth sitting at? 4.2k. He's got a long way to go until that Battle Fury's up and running. While TNC, like you're saying, they don't need to rush around and do anything hasty. Don't need to be, you know, too brash about how they're playing this game. But you just know that one big team fight where they get all those track kills and they put themselves so far ahead, because right now it's 10-5. It was, you know, 10-2, and it felt like TNC were just running away with the game. But their net worth lead is limited. It's not that big. Experience lead is like 2k. They don't have a massive lead to really play around with. So I think they have to be kind of patient as well. They can't just go, you know, balling into a team fight and hope for the track kills to flow, because Taring definitely have the hero levels they need, you know? The Omni Slash is a lot of damage.
For sure, I think Taring's lineup is less item dependent, whereas TNC, you know, the two supports, the Bounty Hunter and Visage, sort of do need items. Bounty Hunter's track is nice, but that's the reason that he often gets mech, and
that's a really good move. Taring with that ward up on the high ground. They move themselves up towards the Ancients and they say good night, Visage. Poor little lad, he's gone, he's done. And that's something that Taring are really on the ball with. You look at their ward down at bottom lane. Lane ward here, watching for anyone that's kind of backing off this lane. And TP's in. No, Ninja's Prophet going to cancel that out. They're going to scout out Roshan here. Helm of the Dominator creep from the Vengeful Spirit. Oh, they're TPing down to bot now. They're going to look for this kill. Raven scouting with the Wave of Terror. Stuns up Ice. But the rest of Taranga are coming in. Ice might just die before his team gets here. Or will he with a grave from Dazzle? And the save from Earth Spirit. They just go in and take them both down. Atihi, he finally gets in with a kill onto Ice's Nature's Prophet. But TNC are losing so much. They don't have the response time here really available to them to counteract what Taranga are doing.
What a bait by Ice. At first, I couldn't believe my eyes. Like, he just TP'd himself right next to a Vengeful and a Spirit Breaker. But he survived just enough, and had it not been for a TP, he would have lived. But fight's not over yet.
Oh, AU! He's still alive! And he's trying to fight through this as well. He'll turn and fight up against the Dazzle. Pretty simple takedown of the charge. We'll swap back onto a lonely range creep down at the bottom lane. All this fighting at bottom, it's giving so much time for Juggernaut up at top to farm away. He's now 1200 gold away from Battle Fury. And that awful timing, it's becoming better and better. It's 12 to 8 now. Taranga have really wedged a comeback in this game.
This is all Zeus, I think. Zeus, despite him, he died 3 times in the lane, and ever since that, he didn't die. And he managed to get a level 7, 8, 9, and basically, every time they, like, no one can tank Zeus right now. Not even Ember Spirit. His Flame Guard's gonna just completely get erased at the start of a fight. And you mentioned Roshan. I think both teams have to be careful about doing Roshan because they're not gonna be that fast. And unless, like, you get a team wipe and then you go for Roshan knowing that there's not gonna be a contest. It's funny because both teams have really good map control. Like, the Ember Spirit with the Boots of Travel and the Spirit Breaker's semi-global presence as well as Furion. So if either side goes for a Roshan, it takes too long and the other team realizes it and they push out the lanes and come contest it, I think it can be like potentially there's more to lose than to gain from the Roshan right now.
Very high risk maneuver. I think you're right. Sentry Ward, I'm not sure if it scouted AU there or if Dazzle had vision, but either way, I'm going to see him in a second. Both teams kind of want to smoke up here. It's a smoke for Taranga, and I think theirs is going to be better timed than the one here from TNC. They were going into the jungle hunting for the Juggernaut. But Ben made a swift rotation towards mid lane, and he's not going to walk into anyone just now. But on the flip side of things, AU, this Bounty Hunter, he's not going to be the one they target towards. They've got vision up onto the high ground here, over towards Ancients. Sam H, Raven, and Winter G Small Sun all around the mid. Yamate, the kick across, is not going to be on the mark. And Taranga, their smoke comes to nothing so far. Both teams, it's just the dance. It's the dance of death between these two teams, you know? Swinging back and forth, smoking, trying to dodge each other, trying to catch each other off guard. It's an incredibly tight game. And with the start we had, it didn't feel like it was going to be.
Nice healing ward snipe by the Visage Birds. Yeah, definitely it's sort of like offense versus offense. It's completely up to the element of surprise and who gets better.
Oh, Yamate, he's caught. He's going to get nuked down.
Doesn't have a grave.
Another strike.
Too far away from Dazzle.
Takes him out and TNC. They split the fight so perfectly. Even Teehee is going to try and find the kill onto the Love Heart. But it's Ben they want. It's Ben. They have eyes for his heart. They're going to try and find him as the Juggernaut runs away, but he's fine behind the Tier 1 tower. And finally, maybe TNC can get this Tier 1 mid. It's something they've kind of been yearning for a while. You know, Taranga have taken down all of their Tier 1s. As Ice has done a great job kind of splitting the map and getting himself around. But TNC have just been focused on farming more than anything. Like, map control has been secondary to their movements. It's been more about getting Teehee items and just trying to dodge Taranga's engagements. Oh, Yamate, have you... No, oh, there's a Dazzle behind him. He's fine.
I think the difference is, until like the 10-minute mark, Raven was really quiet on the Vengeful, and now he's being more proactive, and he feels more comfortable. He has a Yasha. He's gonna... Not sure if that's gonna be a BKB or a Sanjin Yasha. I think it should be a BKB. But anyway, with the levels and the items, he's feeling more confident, and Taranga might go for a Rosh here.
Oh, head themselves into the pit. Now, is this going to be the high-risk, high-reward maneuver you were talking about? The TNC, get themselves into this pit and contest, because they're making their way over.
It's gonna get scouted fairly early into the Roche. And does he have a TP? He doesn't have TP right now, but he can TP onto the bird.
Tracks come out, Roshan's down to about half health. And TNC, they're all prepped and ready. The tracks just keep flowing and the charge in, cancelled out. Good kick and grip back into this with a roll forward. The Thundergod's Wrath is there. No one has died just yet, but Ben is chasing down Sam H with a solo Omni Slash onto the Spirit Breaker. They take him out, but look at that Sleight of Fist. Kick across will only catch AU, but Taring, they have the upper hand in this fight. Sprout is down. There's another slight chains, and they're turning it back. Raven comes in with a stun. The Solar Subject kills off Ice, and they've graved up the Dazzle himself. But Ben, he's being swiped down and slashed to pieces as TNC turn what looked like a pretty awful engagement into a pretty balanced one. As things so far turn out as a 2-for-2, but 3-4-3's dead.
Oh, Teehee.
What's Teehee up to? Oh, wow! He found a Zeus. So from a 2-for-2, it's a 4-for-2 for TNC.
Yeah, I was like same boat as you. I think the fight was going pretty well for Taring, or at least it looked like it, because Joggernaut got the solo kill on the Spirit Breaker, and who else did they kill? The Visage, I think. No, wait. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. The fight was kind of chaotic, but it looked like TNC, they lost their Spirit Breaker, so it looked like TNC wouldn't have a frontliner to kind of re-engage, but Teehee got like two good Sleight of Fists and chain combos off, and then Raven kind of came out of nowhere from the right. He had everything. And I suppose like this Dazzle dying was sort of big, because he's like really the main sustain.
And he graved himself.
Yeah, in the Roche bit. But he survived, so it was like okay for the time being. But
how do you feel about the Hood of Defiance on Bounty Hunter? Like, against the Zeus, I guess it's pretty good. But no mech.
I think Pipe does more against Zeus. I mean, it's cheaper than getting the full Guardian Greaves, for sure. And I don't know. Like, until the Pipe, the Hood is, like, worse than mech, obviously, because it only benefits yourself. Oh, it's also good at Thurster, not to mention.
Oh, yeah. Good point. And I guess
two of the main AoE DPS are Zeus and Earth Spirit, so it's going to be pretty efficient against them.
And they're going to have Veil soon as well. Yamate is, you know, like a third of his way through his Veil. Once that's up, there's a disgusting amount of magic damage between both of the Wraths, Thunder Gods, and Natures. And the Earth Spirit Ebola. Magnetize. It's going to be pretty disgusting. Yamate makes a move down towards bottom lane, but who's hunting in the jungle here? AU has a sentry, no observer wards. I think he's just scouting out, trying to find if anybody's loitering around in this dire jungle. There's Ben. He's got himself Battle Fury Yasha. His farming has been pretty good. He's accelerated his farm with that Battle Fury, of course, just getting himself up and running. But you're looking at Teehee at this point. BOT's drums and was that 230 gold away from his own Battle Fury? Ember Spirit's going to be a hell to play with. In these team fights, there's a BKB's nearly done for Raven as well. So all of that magical damage, Vengeful Spirit's not going to feel an inch of it.
Yeah, Ben's caught up pretty well. Between the Ember Spirit Battle Fury versus Juggernaut Ember Spirit, Juggernaut Battle Fury, it's hard to say which is going to be more impactful. In the long run, I think Juggernaut is, like, him having Battle Fury and Yasha at this point probably secures him like a pretty much full slot if this game goes on for like 50 minutes. For Teehee, it's not the same on Ember Spirit. If he plays carefully, he might just get full slotted, but based on how the game's going, it looks like it's going to be a pretty chaotic fight. I mean, look at the Nature's Prophet item build. He didn't go Midas. He went Phase Boots Blade Mail. He's just looking to, like, he's just looking to fight for the team, and we've seen Ice do that like WTF teleports that almost look suicidal, but it's kind of like a bait for the team. Dire's bottom tower. Because they don't have a Spirit Breaker of their own on Taring. They need someone to just, you know, be like, hey,
go in.
Look at me, man. You're going to ignore me? No, you're going to fight me, and yep, my team's going to come and clean you guys up.
Oh, the phase drums, we've seen a hell of a lot of it. Good for pushing towers and team fighting. The blade mail is something that, you know, we're kind of returning to after the old triple null blade mail build used to be relatively popular. The smoke from TNC won't come to anything. And he's going to wrap themselves through the jungle again find themselves on this tier 2 at mid. Yep. He's blade mailing himself up, but I think this should be his death. It's blade mail against blade mail. The blade mail battle. Sam H against Ice. And Ice dies to a neutral creep. I was so sure the Spirit Breaker was killing him there. Oh, mid lane. Raven, is he caught? It's BKB, but he's dead. Aegis is down. And Raven, he used his swap aggressively there. It looks like he's going to get jumped on again. The Omni Slash bounces up to a Visage Familiar. Oh, it does nothing. And look at that damage output. Yamate throws out that Thunder God's Wrath, but they're all freaking dying. TE just has to go back in with a Shuriken toss. It catches the Zeus and kills him off. And TE just keeps chasing and chasing. He cannot get another Slight Chains onto the Earth Spirit, but I'll catch Ben instead. With no spin, with no Omni Slash, Ben is just trying to fight through under his tier 3. The Visage. Oh, he could have nuked Ben. He could have nuked Ben instead of the Earth Spirit. Winter G Small Sun, a little mistake there, thinking his team had already secured the kill. But TNC. Whew, the fire from this Ember Spirit. Oh boy. Hang on a second. Raven. Oh buddy. Swap. Is he dead? Yeah, the stick charge doesn't keep him alive. Good TP in from Ice. We'll catch him on the back end. Drums himself out. I don't think TNC are going to let this go too lightly. Slight Chains. Weave is there. And maybe a Grave as well. The Dazzle's coming in to save him up. And TNC can't find that kill.
Fight over now? Finally?
Nah, mate. It's going to keep on going for hours.
Yeah, I think it was kind of weird by Raven that I guess TNC really wanted to make a fight there, like, happen, because he swapped in, and there was a moment of hesitation. I mean, there's no way Ember Spirit and a Vengeful are going to combo a Juggernaut. Like, it doesn't work. You have to, like, swap into X or something. Like, swap into Chains is not really a combo against Juggernaut, but that they tried it anyway. Vengeful was sort of in an awkward position, and she turned on BKB, like, in the Tier 2. She was going to die anyway. Usually, you don't activate BKB until your second life when you have Aegis. And, you know, Ben went for that insta-Omni Slash, but it unfortunately bounced to the birds, which is why I think he was allowed to live there at, like, his Tier 3. You know, just kind of like some justice for his bad luck, bad bounces on the Omni Slash.
Nature's Prophet, what are you doing? Oh, you're not allowed to be up here. You're not allowed to... Oh, does he doesn't know, does he? Does he know? Does he realize? Oh, he's going to know now. Oh, he knows! Does he, wait, hang on a second. Yeah, he knows now. Okay, swap him! Get him! Find him! Ice! Oh, the TP away. Visage stuns. Oh, that's perfect. Perfect. How... Like, there was that moment where I thought he knew, and he was, like, running himself back and forth on the Ember Spirit. And then he realized he doesn't know. But then he slight-fisted this area, and he caught him with the Slight Chains. Oh, buddy.
It didn't look like TE knew right away, though. He slight of fisted, but he was, like, still hitting the creeps. And then Ice, he must have auto attack on or something. He hit TE for some reason. He could have just TP'd out, I think.
He would have realized with the chains not hitting the creeps. Like, where did my chains go? Must have gone onto something, right? Because there's no way you miss chains in that scenario, but I get him nonetheless. So, how are we looking? Because a couple of minutes ago, we were looking at TNC having a limited lead. They've actually consolidated that pretty well. Taking out all the outer tier 1s, one of the tier 2s, they've got themselves a good 7,500 lead here. In terms of net worth and a 5k experience lead. So finally, TNC kind of boost that advantage they have over Taring. With Raven getting himself BKB Yasha. What's he going to go into next on this one roll Venge? Do you finish off Manta? Do you go SNY?
Manta would be pretty good against Omni Slash, as we saw what, you know, multiple units can do against Omni Slash with the Visage Birds. If he gets Manta and there's, like, birds and useless illusions, it can make Juggernaut's life pretty miserable. And I think the Omni Slash in this game is really important. Depending on how value his Omni Slash is, what's going to happen is if he Omni Slashes someone pretty, you know, low impact, like the Spirit Burger after he's used all his spells, or like a Bounty Hunter who already got two or three tracks off, what usually happens is if Bounty lives, he's going to keep tracking the Juggernaut, and people are going to be able to kite the Ben, basically. Even with Spirit Breaker's aura if Spiritbreaker is alive, they're going to have like so much movement speed against Juggernaut, so he won't be able to do DPS without Omni Slash. And if they kill the Spiritbreaker, then there's track. So it's like the Bounty Hunter and Spiritbreaker cover each other in terms of like providing, you know, massive movement speed bonuses for the team.
What? Has someone tried to draw Bart Simpson on the map?
Yeah, I think it was a...
I hate it when that happens. Yeah, Visage was drawing some spikes on the map. I can't draw on the map. It goes all squiggly when I try and do it. It's so annoying. Let's take a quick look at items that people have picked up over the past couple of minutes. So Ben, you know, you're talking about the Manta style Battle Fury for him. Dazzle, he's got himself a medallion. There's no treads, there's no arcanes or anything like that just yet from him. But we do have the Zeus having Veil, Aether Lens, and now with the Staff of Wizardry. I'm guessing four staff just for the mobility. Could be a Yule Scepter, but you're never quite sure. You're never quite sure. A lot of it comes down to player preference. What's the Nature's Prophet building? Maelstrom. Gloves of Haste with Mithril Hammer. After the Blade Mail, wants some more DPS. Well, Sam H. Oh man, he's just tanking up for the team, isn't he? Vlad's Cloak, Blade Mail. Plenty of auras coming out of him. Let's run himself in. Well, Winter G Small Sun on the Visage actually has himself a gem. With that pipe on AU, this team fight from TNC is pretty monstrous, honestly. The Manta style is nearly done for this Vengeful Spirit.
Yeah, I think that wars-wise, they're sort of like pretty even. Like the Ember and Venge at the top, the Juggernaut has potential to carry hard if he... Yeah, there's too many damn fights. He's probably thinking, I have my Battle Fury, all my farming tools, but there's like, the team can't function without me, so I can't go out all like beast farm mode. I have to fight at the same time, but it's not exactly the easiest lineup to fight into. Oh, AU. It kind of looks like tearing or hunting down AU, even though I'm sure they don't have vision of
it. It felt that way.
Yeah, it was like a weird sixth sense.
They had a couple of sentries around. Maybe a treant walked across and saw him or something. But AU, he's just keeping tabs on Ben. Keeping these tracks out and flowing 20 seconds until Aegis is, until Roshan respawns. This is something that both teams really have to pay a massive amount of attention to. It might be worth sending like Visage Familiars in or something, just to scout it out.
Yeah, it is going to be that Manta for Raven. Not a bad choice, because Venge has ridiculous stats anyway.
I guess you could send Helm of the Dominator creep into Rosh Pit just to scout it for them. But Ben sends his illusions forth, sees Roshan's alive. Oh, the Familiars are here already. So both teams know the big man's up. And Taring, they're the ones to smoke first. TNC are just wandering around in their own jungle, not wasting any time, farming up and keeping this going. But Taring...
Oh, it's going to be counter smoke from TNC, I think. Is this going to be a funny situation? And I think Taring have the slight edge because of the Zeus. Obviously, when the smoke breaks, they're going to have much more information.
Especially if we walk into them like this, the smoke, oh, 343 pops the dust. They're going to get the Ember Spirit out, but I think AU's dead. The Raven swaps himself in. They want to fight this. The Grave onto the Earth Spirit is going to come out, and there's the Magnetized down. But Ben, he's got the spin to get himself further away. Look at that damage output from TNC. They've taken down four of them already. And Ben, are you going to be able to escape this, my friend? It looks like he barely TPs himself away. Where did that...
clutch play from Raven.
I thought that was hyper-aggressive. I thought he was going to die.
Well, I guess with the BKB, the smart thing is he's only going to die to the Omni Slash, and then he has a Mana Field, so... You swap in, he instantly BKB, that means neither the Zeus or Earth Spirit are able to do anything to him. Not even the Nature's Prophet's ult or the Blade Mail. And then once Juggernaut uses the ult, he's going to Manta and, you know, kind of cross his fingers and walk
Radiant's
away.
Top tower is under attack.
Yeah, this is what I'm talking about when I say it depends on how valued Omni Slash is. Like, that Omni Slash was zero value, didn't kill anyone, didn't even, like, make Venge low, so it takes him out of the fight.
Oh, Ben. You are in trouble here. 9 seconds until he has a TP out, but I think he's just straight up done for.
Oh, at least he dispelled the track before he died.
The small
I mean, like,
things. Seriously. Yeah, I know. It's just funny. Like, But it's the little things, right? It's the little things.
Little things.
He took the ancients. He dispelled track. He didn't give a, didn't give all that track gold to the four people around for TNC. That's pretty nifty.
But I mean, like, enough jokes. Like, there's like Taring's in some trouble now. They don't. They do have buyback on Ben, but oh, I don't think he wants buyback here. Not this.
Well, he does anyway. Yamate swapped in. They've got Rave and BKB up at the grave onto Yamate. Keeps him alive through all this burst damage. I don't think it's going to be enough, though. Ben has Omni Slash ready. He's just going to have to throw it. He's losing too much life, and Samae just dived into the enemy base. With Yamate returning to the fight, Ben clicks back, and the Thunder God's Wrath is good. Samae is taken out, and they want to keep on fighting this. Repel the aggression here from TNC, but Taring, they expend so much gold and time, and they might even lose a couple more if they do go any deeper. Because Ben doesn't have ulti, and TNC are holding the high ground.
I think Taren could have been a little bit more patient. They could have waited and acted like Juggernaut doesn't have buyback or held with Zeus. I mean, it's like the Zeus is going to spam the tier 3 with the Dazzle backing him up and perk pot like an Earth Spirit for counter initiation. They could have waited until like TNC committed, dove like between the tier 3s and tier 4, and then Juggernaut buys back and like, TP's into a nice location. And naturally, TNC are likely going to split up, and then he can get a good Omni Slash. But he kind of like bought back it as soon as TNC walked up the hill, which was kind of like it could have been much more, you know.
And this Venge's got some serious balls. Just honestly, the amount of times that Raven just swaps into a position where, in my head, it's like, what the hell is he doing? But that BKB Manta is so good up against this Taring team. It saves him from every scenario. Every situation is pretty much planned for and countered by TNC before it even happens. Vengeful Spirit just swaps with impunity. Whoever she sees, she swaps. Get the kill, get the pick off, force the grave. And all these team fights, they're just working out absolutely just beautifully for TNC, honestly. The double buyback there from Taring, things are looking rough. Pretty bloody rough. What's Ben got now? He did go for that Manta a while back. 2,700 gold is what he saved up so far. I mean, what's... Is there a big item in this game that either... Oh, he's going to go for the Basher. I mean, Abyssal against the Ember Spirit is pretty good, but... The funny thing is, in every one of these fights, right, we're looking at the Venge swapping in, we're looking at Samage charging into the back, Bounty Hunter tracks, Visage, you know, stunning with familiars and throwing out soul assumptions. But there's this one fiery guy just standing in the background, you know, giggling to himself and rubbing his hands together going, hehehehe, just spamming Sleight of Fist. We don't see him, but he's doing so much bloody damage. Taring can't touch. There's no way that Taring can, like, walk past Spirit Breaker and Venge to get to the Ember.
He was doing so much with just one Battle Fury, and Ember Spirit is one of those heroes where you kind of like, oh boy, Visage. Like, Taring have to be careful now. They know Omni Slash is down.
Oh, there's a slight change. There's a grave still available, but Raven just walks in. They've killed the Dazzle down already, and there's no grave left. Raven, you're right, he's got that secondary life, and 343 gone, buddy, dead. Ben takes out Raven's first life, but there's five of them paying the price. That's the ultimate one. All of their lives are forfeit.
That was the point where they killed the Visage, and Ben has to be like, okay, guys, we have to, like, just get the fuck out of here. Like, we couldn't really even win a fight when we killed the Spirit Breaker with Omni Slash. We're not going to win a fight when we take out the Visage with Omni Slash. Like, we just have to get out of here. And Dire's top tower, I don't know. It's like, when you get a free kill like that, you have to realize it's actually not free. Like, you use your most important spell in your entire team lineup. Like, Omni Slash, that's pretty much it.
Goodbye, tier 3 tower. Goodbye, Rax, it looks like, with no glyph available. Taring going to have a difficult time defending up against this. One of the little birdies is dead. Hey, birds. What a hey, Earth Spirit. Swapped back. The grave is good from the Dazzle. But with these bashes and lockdown, they'll even catch ice on the back. Samage, infinite range on his nether strike. Global power and the first best of one between TNC and Team Taring. Oh man, does it go the way of TNC? 36-14. Taring made a good comeback, like 15 minutes in. But it was downhill from there.
It was like the early game, TNC just completely wrecked him the laning stage. And out of the laning stage, you talked about, like, pre-draft that Taring's a team that focused on the mid-game, like that 20 to 30 minute timing push. And we saw, like, the potential of their lineup when they can just, all out of nowhere, it appears, probably from TNC's point of view, it appears like Taring just appear as a five-man and kill someone, take a tower, and repeat. But TNC kind of, you know, organized himself, and I always thought about TNC as a team that they play really good Dota if they understand what the game is. Like, I've, like, the games where it TNC disappoint are the types of games where they don't really know how to approach the game. But, like, this game, they had a pretty straightforward lineup against a pretty straightforward, you know, opposing lineup, and they just went for kills, and they got items, and they've understood when they can be confident with, like, that Aegis BKB timing on the Venge. And after she got Manta, she felt invincible. It feels like a classic TNC game.
Yeah, relatively crisp, well executed, and Taring didn't have anything to really counteract it. The Zeus pick was good, but in the end, it didn't even matter. As we head into our next best of one, Taring take on TNC again. Of course, this is a double round robin for WePlay Season 3 in the SEA group stage. So we've got the same matchup, and it's a grudge match this time for Taring. So we'll be back in a couple of minutes, guys. We'll get into the lobby and get ourselves into the next game as quickly as we can. So go and get a quick snack. Go and get, you know, one of those red velvet love heart cupcakes you've made for yourselves on Singles Day. Or unless it's Valentine's Day for you and you've got a lovely partner. Get yourselves a snack. We'll be back in a couple of minutes, guys.